Ayo, Jackson Myzation here, and here to talk about, is Kimimaru related to Kaguya Otsutsuki? Let's go. Stop a nigga when I saw him. Stop the proud nigga, I'm ballin'. Big jack niggas, I don't like when you be ballin', cause I'm a real nigga and we never been to college. Real niggas stay up in the gutter where we came from. Teaching all the little motherfuckers how we came up. Stayed up, got a little rich, I got a bitch and then we hail up. These whack niggas, real niggas wanna rise down. New bitch saw me, then she spread, so to calm down. Okay, now, this topic is a old topic. This is an old topic that really wasn't confirmed at all by Kishimoto. The topic at hand is Kimimaru related in any type of way to Kaguya? Or is Kaguya a descendant of Kimimaru and his clan? And I'm here to get my thoughts and opinions on this topic and try to answer this today, actually. So Kimimaru, why does he have anything to do with the mother of Shinobi? You may be saying they have nothing in common, that they are two separate characters that has no contact with each other, and that they both are irrelevant to each other. But today, I'm finna show y'all some huge similarities that they have throughout the series, even when they didn't have any contact with each other. Okay, so let's get this started. The main reason why this question even came up in the first place was because Kimimaru and Kaguya look just alike. And when I tell you they look just alike, I mean they look just alike. Now obviously, Naruto had worse graphics than Naruto Shippuden. So Shippuden has better graphics, but as you see here, they both have white hair. And you could say it's a different shade and all, but it's white hair. Naruto had less graphics than Naruto Shippuden, so that's why the white hair on Kaguya is more detailed than the white hair on Kimimaru. But on Kimimaru, you see he has two red dots on his forehead, he has the white hair, and he has the zigzag part in his hair. Now Kaguya has the same zigzag part in her head with the same white hair. So that's two out of the three similarities of Kimimaru that checked off. But what about the third one? What about the two red dots on her forehead? Obviously, she does not have two red dots on her forehead. She has more of two ovals on her forehead. And as you see here, they're more separated than the two dots on Kimimaru's forehead. So you can easily say that their forehead does not match. You can say it's different shapes and colors. And you can say that they're not similar in any way. But you can still count it. Let me tell you why I say that. So for this, you need to look at her God Tree form, or the form she took after she ate the God Tree. Now, as you see, she has the same two dots on her forehead, but the difference here is the red Rene Sharingan on her forehead. So you can say because she has the red Rene Sharingan on her forehead, that's why the two dots on Kimimaru's forehead is red. And for the shape, it differs from the anime and the manga. But between the two, it's just a simple circular form. Rather, it's an oval or a triangle with round edges. So simply, you can safely put the dots on Kaguya's forehead as just round or circle. Just like the dots on Kimimaru's forehead. So the forehead similarities is still there and not void in the conversation of if they look alike. So is that it? It's because they look similar. The only reason why they asked the question if they are related in any type of way? Hell no, we're not even close to half of the video yet. So what other similarities is there between Kimimaru and Kaguya? Well, guess what Kimimaru's full name is. Kimimaru's full name is Kimimaru Kaguya. That's another main reason on why people ask if Kimimaru and Kaguya is related in any type of way. Because Kaguya's first name is Kimimaru's last name and his clan's name, the Kaguya clan. But as you see here, the Kaguya clan has the same attire as Kimimaru, minus the white hair. They have the zigzag parts in their hair and they have the red dots on their forehead. So Kimimaru's clan is named after Kaguya and they have the same similarities of Kaguya Otsutsuki. But that's not even it of the similarities between Kaguya and Kimimaru's clan. Let me tell you more about the Kaguya clan and the Keke Genkai. The Kaguya clan has a Keke Genkai, which they control their entire bone structure. They can eject any bones out their body to use it as a weapon, as a shield, etc. It's a Keke Genkai, meaning it's only for their clan. And here comes Kaguya using the exact same Keke Genkai that the Kaguya clan uses. She ejects her bones out of her body and uses those said bones that she is ejecting to attack her opponent. And no, it's not truth-seeking rods, because truth-seeking rods are black. And she is shown using them earlier, and they was shown to be black. But as you see, Kaguya uses her bones to attack her enemy, just like Kimimaru and his clan uses their bones to attack their enemies. That is a huge similarity, especially if you bring in the fact that it's a Keke Genkai. Only people from that specific clan can use that Keke Genkai. So why is Kaguya, when her last name is Osutsuki, using this bone Keke Genkai? Her name isn't Kaguya Kaguya, because that would sound weird as shit. So why is she using the Kaguya clan's Keke Genkai when she's an Otsutsuki? Well, I found an answer for this, and the conclusion I find will shock you. And I am 110% sure that the proof that I show you right now will prove to you and make you believe that Kimimaru is related to Kaguya in a way. Okay, as you see here, the Kaguya clan have a ponytail bun on both sides of their head. And when Kaguya first lands on Earth, she comes in contact with the first human she meets. And they have the exact same hairstyle as the Kaguya clan. Now, I'm pretty sure you're knowing where I'm going with this. That's a major coincidence that the Kaguya clan has the exact same hairstyle as the humans that Kaguya herself first comes in contact with. You just can't ignore that major similarity right there. So because of this, here's my final conclusion and the answer of the question on the topic at hand. Okay, so Kaguya first lands on Earth. That's when the first humans that she comes in contact to sees her and bring her to the king of the land of Su. This is when Kaguya and the king have a romantic relationship together and gets married. Soon after, her husband's people find her suspicious and thinks that she's a witch. They attempt to attack and arrest Kaguya, but she ain't having that shit, so she ends up killing a couple of their men. Then she goes to the divine tree, eats the fruit, and puts everybody, even her husband, in the infinite Tsukuyomi. But guess what, Kaguya? He ends up planting that seed and getting your ass pregnant. Now she has two children, Hagoromo and Hamura. Then when they're all grown up, they find out that Kaguya placed everybody in the past generation of humans under the infinite Tsukuyomi, and that she hid them underground to turn them into the white Zetsu clones. That's when they wasn't having none of that shit and sealed Kaguya away in the moon. Then after the fight with their mother, they paid respect to their father that was sealed up away in the infinite Tsukuyomi a couple of years earlier, and also respect to their mother, and created the clan, the Kaguya clan. For the respect of their father, they gave the Kaguya clan the same hairstyle of him and his people that he was leading. And in honor of their mother, they named the clan the Kaguya clan. They added the zigzag part in their hair as a traditional hairstyle of the clan. And they added the two red dots on the clan's forehead to symbolize the red Rene Sharingan and the two white dots on her forehead. And finally, they gave the clan one of the abilities that Kaguya had, her ability to manipulate the bones in her body. So simply putting it, the Kaguya clan is in honor of Hagoromo and Hamura's dead two parents. Wow, which just got depressing. But skip a few hundred years, and the clan got cocky over the powers that they were given. They attempted in a coup d'etat and got annihilated in the process. And finally, leaving Kimimaru Kaguya as the lone and final survivor of the Kaguya clan. And that really didn't last long because, well, we all know what happened to him. Yeah, he died and the Kaguya clan was no more. So that's the simple story of the Kaguya clan. And yes, to answer the question, Kimimaru is related to Kaguya, and Kaguya is a great descendant from Kimimaru. Unless Kishimoto says fuck my theory and retcon the whole damn thing. But I am 110% sure that this is correct. But anyway, if you like what you saw, please like and subscribe for more content. Hit that bell button to be the first to see my videos.
Watch my previous videos.
Comment your thoughts and opinions down below. I love y'all, and Jacksonization out.